Hello, my name is Luis Astudillo and I'm developing a PhD thesis related to the neotectonics of the Liquiñe-Ofqui fault system with emphasis on the seismic hazard assessment. The Liquiñe-Ofqui fault system is a dextral transpressive trench parallel fault system who partially accommodates the oblique convergence between the Nazca and South American plates. It has been active since at least the Pliocene, conducting deformation at rates ranging between 13 and 32 millimeters per year. Nowadays, it is characterized by shallow microseismicity reaching magnitudes of 4 and depths of 12 kilometers. However, it has been capable to nest magnitude 6 earthquakes related to volcanic eruptions like the Aysén seismic crisis in 2007. Despite the latter, little is known about the millennial timescale behavior of this structure, precluding any evaluation of the seismic hazard. Taking in consideration that the Liquiñe-Ofqui fault system has accommodated deformation since the Pliocene and is capable to nest magnitude 6 earthquakes, our research question is: how has the Liquiñe-Ofqui fault accommodated convergence-induced deformation during the Holocene? And other secondary questions are: deformation concentrates along one or several traces. The faults accommodate deformation by stick slip, a seismic creeping, or by a mix of these two mechanisms. And finally, what are the slip rates of these structures? To answer these questions, we have selected several sites along our study area that show evidence of post-glacial activity along Liquiñe-Ofqui fault traces. Fieldwork allows us to identify post-glacial deformation in the intra-arc area. The construction of stratigraphic sections and collecting samples to obtain radiometric ages or to perform tephrochronological correlations allows us to constrain the timing of the deformation. Topographic surveys allow us to build high-resolution digital topographic models for morphometric analysis and offset estimations using geomorphological markers delimited upon these same orthomosaics. The work carried out so far allows us to estimate the first Holocene slip rate for a trace of the Liquiñe-Ofqui fault system. East of the Liquiñe village, the Liquiñe fault has dextrally displaced the river canyon and deformed Mesozoic basement rocks, as well as fluvial terraces located at both sides of the river. The construction of stratigraphic columns, together with radiometric dating and tephrochronological correlations, allow us to constrain the age of the displacement, and by means of high-resolution topography, we delimited displacement markers and estimated the magnitude of the offset. In this way, we obtained that the Liquiñe fault has moved at a rate of 18.8 millimeters per year during the last 9,000 years. We have collected evidence of post-glacial activity along the Liquiñe-Ofqui fault system, confirming that this structure was active during the Holocene. We haven't found evidence of individual paleoearthquakes within our studied area. Nevertheless, the inferred kinematics for the studied fault traces are consistent with present-day focal mechanisms, suggesting that the behavior of the Liquiñe-Ofqui fault system during the Holocene was similar to that of the present. The glacial cycles and the uninterrupted volcanic activity since the glaciation onset along the southern Chilean Andes downgrade or mask any stratigraphic or morphological manifestation of fault activity, limiting the number of sites with evidence of Holocene deformation along the intra-arc area. Nevertheless, the rivers, streams, and other geomorphological markers related to the development of the stream network have been very useful to perform offset estimations and also slip rate calculations along different branches of the Liquiñe-Ofqui fault system. Muchas gracias por su atención.